Disney on fire right now, but earnings report that blew past estimates in terms of revenues and even parks that were thought to be compromised by prices that were so high, people were balking at going to them. Turns out that was not and is not the case. So the stock is up appreciably about 12% as we speak.
I think we're seeing what happens when you have good execution from a fiscally responsible standpoint, the cost cutting that is almost $8 billion back to pre-pandemic cash flow levels, but also a strategic focus that is clear. Putting the customer at the center with the streaming, the ESPN new package, the
right.
Fortnite investment of $1.5 billion that is tapping into that youthful, you know, engagement that video games are taking away from mass media.
Right.
So it's very smart to see that balance, and I want to praise the executive team because they've stayed focused and they've delivered.
Yeah, Bob Iger was looking like he was staggering for a while.
Yeah.
He talked about cutting prices for visitors to parks and all the rest. I don't know if that was reflecting the latest quarter. The park attendance was still super strong. People paying through the nose to get in there. So that probably has not changed, but it is a testament to strength of the consumer.
Yeah, the resilience of the consumer, which is one of those puzzling numbers in all of the economics that we analyze. Despite inflation, the consumer is strong. I think we still have aftermath PTSD from COVID and the desire for live experiences. And they've been very smart at packaging beyond the ticket experiences that you have to pay for the genies and then all this other stuff
that
and the merch. It is unbelievable,
right.
And families are still going
they
into
are
debt to go to Disney.
Do it. Does that part worry you that you always hear this, the consumer spending like crazy, but he, she is doing so on credits?
I think, unfortunately, it is the realities of what we're seeing in the numbers of the of the debt. And now it's the defaulting payment ratios as well that are increasing and are concerning. I'm hoping the economy will bounce back and tell us a different story. But I do want to underscore something on Disney, which we were talking about offline.
Sure.
They know who their consumer is. And one interesting factor, which you hear me talk about the Hispanic or diverse communities here, the population under 18 is already majority minority nationally.
Interesting.
And Disney knows that. When you look at the type of content, the talent, the storylines, it wasn't just Coco when that movie came out. The stuff they do during holidays, the quinceañera packages they have at the parks, those are very profitable and culturally intelligent and relevant moves that they're layering on top of good execution and great strategy. So I know some people at Disney, they know this is a key strategy, especially with Hispanic children and families that are bigger on average versus the average non-Hispanic household. So they're betting on the numbers.